What you Ranger Sports, Ranger Sports, and Arena International Field. My job really is to reach out to you and say, it is to ask questions. I haven't got all the answers. Okay? Your job is to say to me, this is how I would use this or something like it. Okay? And that's the big thing. So if I'm going to present this to you, can you make notes mentally, write it down, whatever, and just say, I'm buying into that. That would probably need to change a bit if I was going to make sense of this, and I would just need to get rid of that. But compartmentalize here, you're thinking of those three areas for me. By the end of the session, I'm hoping I have feedback to develop the coaching aspect of this. Okay, the coaching too. It might be the case, it works as it is. Who knows? I'm going to take you through where it's coming from, and then we'll get on to the practical side, because I'm going to try to see the app itself. This isn't just about me, this is a big team of people over the past. It started here in Leeds in 2001. We had a multi-skills academy. Remember multi-skills in England, the multi-skills movement? We were the first, we designed the first multi-skills academy here. 80 of the best children, 25,000 children in Yorkshire. Yeah, at the age of 10, coming in here. We had people like Stuart Lancaster, around the section of here. So people from National Rugby Bodies of Sport came around sessions in a multi-skill, multi-sport type of perspective that tried to say, sport is the beyond any more of child development, it's movement. If we improve the movement with the children, it doesn't matter which sport we go into. We struggled a bit. We didn't have a lot of water sports in there. We didn't have an outdoor adventure, activity type element to it either. It was sort of like games and athletics and gymnastic type of oriented. Okay? So there were pros and cons a bit. 2 years working with the sports just come developing that program, and then guess what? It moved on. Funding went somewhere else. What happened then is about 8 years ago, another program started up called Start to Move. I was just briefly talk to you a little bit about that. And we started that here. We designed the program with a range of people nationally. And then that was delivered to 7,000 teachers. Okay. At the end of that, the problem was we didn't have a tool to assess the movement of children. So how did we know who was working? So in the same way as I work with children, how do we know that what we're doing is actually making a difference? Now, technically, tactically, we will probably get some key indicators of how they're fitting into your sport. But what if a child changes sport? And let's face it, I'm talking about children between the ages of 4 and 7. There's a 90% chance they will go into different sports. Very few of them stay on a linear sport track. My job is to say, it's not about sport development, it's about child development. I'm sure certain other people have said a similar type of thing. So if you want to do that, you need a tool to measure it. Agreed? At the moment, was serving on the side of the project. And that's the crux of it. So the team that we're involved in, the Youth Sport Trust funded program as well with Leeds, Beckett, and John Moores University, and now it's switched to Sheffield Valley, and they've got it from as well. Lots of different people involved, just to acknowledge that, it's not just me as an individual. I'm going to take you through the background, I'm going to take you through what the problem was, how we solved it, what did we find as we were trying to solve it. Just to kind of like imagination a little bit. And then what the last section is the important, what does it mean for you? We're going to go off and you're going to do 14 movement tasks that we've created. So what was the problem? So you're all involved in working in various ways with children, or you're educating coaches, you're going to work with children. But this is the problem for our children at the moment. It doesn't matter what sport they're in, it's that they are the same child. Okay, so my focus is about the child. They've got a reduced play radius in 1950. The play radius of the child is about 6 miles in England. They used to walk across quarries and go into the woods, and only go back when they got hungry and they needed something to eat. And the mum or the dad called them in. Okay. In the 1980 census, that radius had shrunk to a mile. Okay. And the mile basically was, it would let them go with friends places. We've got an increase in motorised transport, there's a heightened sense of stranger danger, and we've got some real issues in society.
society accepting the fact that children can be independent and can go where they want to go.
In 2010, on the latest census, the play range is from
100 metres
a street. 100 metres is a typical play range of the child shown by Play England. So today in this context, quite similar across Europe, at least, around how that play context is shown. So we've got a real issue with children not playing outdoors, not climbing trees, not playing with friends in the games that they probably used to play, okay? Not playing the Cops and Robbers types of games, and the kind of tactical sense of how you kind of operate within these. And not moving. I'm definitely not moving like what we did in the past. We've got another bit of evidence around the time is evidence of activity, which leads to child obesity issues on the moment. There is a direct correlation between fundamental movement skills, I want to talk about, physical activity, and child obesity. I think what people miss is the link between movement and child obesity. And there is a link, because if children can't move effectively, they're less likely to participate in physical activity, and physical activity is a key determinant in child obesity. So I'm really keen that we understand the broader perspectives now as well. I'm giving you some ammunition. You're going to have to go back and convince somebody somewhere that doing this is what we need to do. I've been in those environments. I go to DCMS, I have to convince people. But I'm one person convincing people at the policy level. You're going to have to go and convince people that this is what we need to do for children. Okay? The low levels of primary PE training. We do primary PE here at Carnegie. On average, a primary school PE teacher, primary school general teacher, because in England we have, they teach all subjects, we don't have primary PE specialists. Couple of hundred every year that I'm paying, but generally aren't. Do you know how much time that primary school teacher gets, primary school teacher gets to train to be able to deliver physical education in primary school? In a few days. A couple of days?
6 hours.
6 hours? Exactly. You're good. You need months of that level. You're leaving this level of time. 6 hours. To educate our next generation of youngsters in terms of their physical education. So we've got some issues. These are still there. This was a reason why we did things 8 years ago. Nothing's changed. In fact, it's got worse. Okay? So that's the problem. Another thing that we've got as well is the children's movement. Has anyone seen this thing today? Aging stage approach? Has anyone not seen it? Be honest, I'm going to ask you a question. You've all seen it, yeah? This age and stage approach. That's good because when I used to live in the next year, no one had seen it. That's fantastic news, isn't it? That we're actually know about general children's movement. So we know that children work their way through various stages of development in relation to their development ability. So they'll go from being a child, survival skills like sucking the thumb in the womb. Movement before they then move into the world, learn how to sit upright, that we're all doing at the moment, without any major conscious effort or environment basis, it's probably a little bit harder. Have a few beers, that becomes even harder. But for a child, that's something they have to learn. They'll learn certain rudimentary and reflexive skills early. This is where the problem starts. If they don't learn certain fundamental movement skills in this window of opportunity, between about the age of 4 and 6, the likelihood of them progressing through into these complex and functional skills that you see in our everyday types of sports activities is hindered. Okay? So it's now or never. To be quite positive here, I think in sport, like physical education, we accelerate children too quickly through that. We try to get them here too quickly, and we don't stay here enough. We don't concentrate on movement. I think it's a hell of a lot better than what it used to be. But my problem is we really don't know a lot of the time what how to identify a children's movement and how to work with children in that particular way. Certainly more than the 7,000 primary school teachers that I've worked with, or primary teachers that I've worked with, who've had 6 hours of training. And they're good, or they're similar to good, if they've done a bit of tempo, or done a bit of running, or something like that. And lo and behold, before you know it, in many cases, they become completely coordinated. That was a good skill. It's a sign you see too often. And what we've done with a slightly different perspective in the group. These three areas are crucial for today. Stability, object control, and work promotion. Now this is an adaptation of David Galloway's work really, as he calls it manipulative, non-manipulative, manipulative, and locomotor. I can't even say those words. Okay, so there's no way I was ever going to use those terms. So what we have to do is think about something catchy that we use to for people to remember. The Rugby Football Union, we use that now, we use Sport Trust, use it, certainly the FAs, I'm working with them, British Cycling, I use it. I think more people are accepting this as a movement, away from the standard movement, the Rugby movement. If we're okay with that, it's a village object to control locomotion, just remember that. That drops out, and we're working in this little area here, 4-7. I can talk a little bit more about where that. This is starting to move the project. We want to know a little bit more about it, the report, tell us what worked, what didn't work. It was effective. Children's movement, and it was a lead-based study across 50 schools in Leeds. Children's movement improved over 3 years. It was the longest study of its kind, with the largest cohort of its kind, okay, ever. Like I said, I'm not that, going around the world for the last 3 years, set telling people, I know what's big study. The biggest downside to it was Ken Tilton on the study, he's just there, presented it as well, he came on and got all the statistics around it. Biggest problem was teachers were saying, hey, you've come and measured these kids, and we've seen you measuring them for 3 months. What the answer was, it starts to lose track. Ah, it's a pretty good question, that. Talk about a little bit about how you might set it up. you're working today, you're working for you, you're working for your money. So I'm going for this bench. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 12, 18, 22. So 7 in the group, so 5 as the and 7. If you want to come off and work into that third pair, you can use this iPad here. Shut up, all the time.
We're going to be talking about Thank you. So it would be great to see how this would progress. Skilled thrower, you can make it better.
that time and catch those girls and things. Okay, so some of the tasks as I thought that I do have to throw against the wall to be seen. So we're trying to take out the significance of an external factor. Okay. The obstacle, so this is the interesting thing. I would love to talk about how we can set that up now. How would you set 30 years to come through that door in 10 minutes? How would you set it up? Okay. I would love for them just to come in and play. In my concept, in 5 years' time, when the technology is there, I will be able to hold the iPad and it will capture certain functions of rooms algorithmically and give me where every child is.
Thank you.